So guys, I found some methods to optimize Marvel's Spider-Man Remastered PC for AMD Ryzen APUs with onboard Vega integrated graphics to get more stability and performance. All the methods which I am going to show in this video are applicable for Ryzen onboard Vega integrated GPUs. However, you can still apply most of the settings if you have a non-Ryzen system, even if you have an external GPU. After changing all these settings, you will see a performance increase not only in Spider-Man Remastered, but in almost all other games too. So let us begin. First, you need to update the Radeon graphics or iGPU driver to the latest version, and then you need to clear the shader cache and the temporary files of your system. If you do not have any of the latest versions of the graphic drivers, then you can simply visit the manufacturer's website to get the latest GPU driver. Now, if you are using a Ryzen onboard Radeon Vega graphics without any external GPU or graphics card, then you can increase the VRAM of the Radeon Vega iGPU. For this, you have to access your system's BIOS interface to tweak the iGPU's VRAM. However, you cannot change the VRAM of any graphics card or external GPU, so this setting is exclusively valid for Ryzen's Radeon Vega iGPU users only. Now, to enter the BIOS, restart your PC. After a few seconds, you can see the logo of your motherboard's manufacturer on your screen. You will be asked to enter a specific key to enter into the BIOS. Just keep on pressing the key at that moment and you will enter into the BIOS. The BIOS interface varies from one motherboard model or series to another. Now, I have already made a video on this topic, that is how to change the VRAM of any Ryzen iGPU. You can click on the I button or click on the link given in the description below to watch that video. Make sure to follow the steps shown on our previous video. There I have explained each and every steps regarding the way to change the VRAM capacity of Vega iGPU. Now guys, don't exit the BIOS after changing the VRAM capacity. You need to disable CPU virtualization from the BIOS itself. Video games are more GPU dependent. CPU virtualization generally increases the CPU usage when we are performing any non-CPU intensive or any GPU intensive task, like gaming. But if you run virtual machines or use any kind of emulator or any other CPU dependent programs, then you need to enable CPU virtualization. So try to enable or disable this feature according to your situation and preference. For this, click on the Advanced tab, go to CPU Configuration, scroll down and toggle SVM mode on or off. This setting name could be different, dependent upon your motherboard and processor. After changing all the settings and the VRAM of the iGPU, save all the changes and exit from the BIOS. You can open the Task Manager, and on the CPU section under the Performance tab, you can see that virtualization is disabled now. But don't worry, you can enable virtualization anytime from the BIOS if it is required. Second, after tweaking all those settings, you need to clear the shader cache and the temporary files from your system. Again, I have already mentioned those steps in our previous video only. Simply follow those steps shown in that video, and you're good to go. Third, now it's time to tweak Marvel's Spider-Man Remastered PCs and game settings. Log into your Steam or Epic Games account from where you have brought the game. If you have the game on Steam, then launch the game from Steam Desktop mode only, and don't use the Steam Big Picture mode for the time being. This is because we do not get to access the game's launcher if we use Steam Big Picture mode. Launch the game, and from the game launcher, click on Settings. Now, choose the window mode as exclusive full screen, then select the resolution to 900p, and choose the aspect ratio of your monitor. Set upscaling to IGTI, and set dynamic resolution to 45, and turn VSync on. Now click on the Graphics tab. Select the preset to low. Now, change the following settings one by one. Set texture quality to medium, and texture filtering to 2x anisotropic. Set depth of field to high. Select ambient occlusion to SSAO. Set motion blur to 10, that is max, and reduce film grain strength to 0. Also, don't forget to adjust the sharpness as per your display, and the effect settings, that is bloom, vignette, chromatic abbreviation and lens flare. Well, they are optional. You can either turn these effects on or off. These effects generally have a negligible impact on performance. After all these changes, click on OK. Now click on Play to launch the game. The game will take some time to regenerate the shader cache, but after 2 to 5 minutes of gameplay, the game will become much stable and smoother. Now guys, I am going to show some benchmarks of Spider-Man Remastered. I am recording this footage with my phone's back camera. Guys, I am running this game on my Ryzen 3 2200G and Radeon Vega onboard integrated graphics, that is without any external graphics card, and I am currently on Windows 10 Pro, version 21H2, as you can see here. You can see the benchmarkings on the top left side, but first, let me show you the game settings once again. I am not going to cut anything from this benchmarking portion, as you can see. I have not changed any in-game settings. All settings are same as before launching the game. With the settings, I am getting an average around 35 to 37 FPS. The frame rate does exceed above 40. You may face some dip below 30 frames for 1 or 2 seconds. However, it would not ruin your experience. So guys, this is how you can play Spider-Man Remastered PC properly. Many users are facing various issues in the game. But don't worry, both PlayStation Studios and Nixxes are providing constant updates and patches to fix the game issues. So we can hope that the game will be more optimized and will get better in the future. And with that being said, if any of you guys have any question, then comment them down below in the comments section. Thank you so much guys for watching the video, wishing you all a great time ahead. And most importantly guys, don't forget to check this video to know about the steps of changing the VRAM of Radeon Vega iGPU.